Hello there, and welcome back to another Thunderous Productions video. I'm the madman behind the mic, Jag Thunder, and this is Minecraft. And what's up, guys, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Build a Military Airfield. I believe we are on episode 23, 4, 5, 6. It'll be in the title. You guys are following a little bit closer than I am as far as the numbers go. I don't know until the day that I upload it. Not really. I just looked at it a few minutes ago, and I've completely forgot. But anyways, we are back to the airfield, and the last episode we finished up the main entrance way down there, and I showed you the road shift, and then we come over here, and we talked about what we were going to do next. What are we going to do next? The medical facility or the hospital. I've got a big area done. I've done a lot of prep work for this one off camera. I spent several days getting this ready just to make things a lot easier. And this is kind of non-typical the way I build things. Usually I build things and then I do a lot of the landscaping around it. This time I wanted to try things a little bit different. I want to try to do the landscaping first and then go back in and put the building in. So anyways, this is what I have so far. I talked about tying this corner in, putting some kind of a checkpoint here, and decided against that. I thought it just made more sense just to make the roads wrap around, and this is going to be the main base, or the main road going through the base. So we'll just carry this on, carry it around all the way down to the other end of the airfield, and just putting some fencing up along here. And if some crazy bastard drives out on the runway, well, he's probably going to get shot anyways. So anyways, we're going to fly down here. We're going to take a few minutes to look at the awesome landscaping because I've put a lot of time into it. And some of it will probably and more than likely get ripped back out because some of the trees got a little close, got a little crazy with the world painter and the cheese whiz. Who likes cheese whiz? Thumbs up if you like cheese whiz. Anyways, so this is the main facility. It's going to go right back in here, and we'll fly over there here in just a minute. And then there's some sub-facilities that will go here. Some parking, I think, goes here and here, and then another facility goes here and here. I think that's why I left that stone. And again, this is very, very roughed out. It will change as I build through this series or these few episodes. Again, we're going to be trying to keep it to... Siri's jumping up at me from my phone. You're stupid. Keeping it to about 4, maybe 5 episodes. That's what we're shooting for. This one may go a little bit longer because there's several buildings, but it just depends on the style of each building. If I decide to change each one, we will go ahead and continue through the episodes, or we will start the main building, and if that's going to be the style, I will go ahead and lay it out and finish it up, and then show it to you in the final episode, like I've been doing on the entrance. Is kind of where I started doing that. But anyways, it's a pretty big building. It's going to be a really nice size here, I think. So that's why I said it will probably take several episodes to get through. This has definitely got to take a little bit of work, and you can see some of my environmental stuff has trickled out into my road over there. So like I said, this here is going to be like kind of like a main entrance for an ambulance. So this would be the ER part here. And then the main entrance is up here. And this is what you should have seen already. Hopefully I've already posted it over the video. And this is the way we're going to be looking at the front of the building. So there's some three sections that you see on the front of that picture. And then this just wraps around. There should be another picture probably somewhere. If you haven't seen it, it'll be up right now, of the overall layout. And guys, you can go on Google Maps or Google Earth and pick up the exact same thing that I did. Just took a screenshot of it, scaled it up, scaled it down a little bit, threw it in World Painter, got the rough outline, threw some trees, pulled up the ground, put in all my little ground effects, went through, bone milled it, like I said, several days and several hours getting this land prepared. So yeah, a lot of time goes into this shit, just prepping for some of these builds. But anyways, you can do the same thing by just going to those sites that I just told you, either like Google Maps or Google Earth, find what you want. And if you're on PC, it makes it so much easier because we have a lot of tools at our disposal. Anyways, enough babbling. We are going to get started. We are going to be building out of quartz, I believe.
And quartz. I think I want to stick with some nether brick for some of the trim. Where's the other piece at? We need the... Oh, I'm sure I will cut this piece out because I had it ready, and I was getting ready to record, and I decided to do more, and then I emptied my inventory. Oh, we're going to do sandstone, too. We're going to keep up with the sandstone shit, so we'll have some stairs, and that's not that right there. Where is the fucking... Right there. All right, now we have all the materials that we need, and I can't quite see the main entrance behind that sign. I don't think I have a close-up image of the front, and I don't. So we're going to have to wing some of this.
I'm sure there's... kind of like an overhang right here, like there is on most hospitals. If there's not, this is going to get one. So we're going to start on the outside, and then we've got some red on the bottom. We do have red on the bottom. Let's go ahead and get that out of the way first. What do you want to use for the red? We've got several questions from episode 23 that I will be pulling from. Hopefully we get through all of them. If not, I'll get through half of them, and then we'll go through some more on the next
episode. So if you submitted a question for episode 23 and I don't get to it, it will be in the next one. Should I use brick? I don't really want to use brick, I don't think. I want to use something red, but not too red. The clay is too red. That's too red.
Let's go with the red wool for right now, and let's see what that looks like. Let's just get placing some blocks, and let's see what we come up with. That's where the three towers go, and then this is going to be in front of that. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then we'll come from this side. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How many was that? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And I'm using CUDA shaders, for those that ask. I switched through between CUDA shaders and Choco Pick. I decided to use CUDA on this one just because it's the render distance is a lot further out and it doesn't give me the fog effect, and I wanted you to see a lot more of what was going on up here. The Choco Pick's nice, but the fog effect comes in really close. It's nice for doing like the water stuff. But anyways, yeah, that's what I'm using. So 3, we're going to go 4, 5, 6 high, I think. Looks good for right now, and we're just getting some blocks. We will, of course, adjust as we go. Whoops, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I will put questions here in just a half a second after I lay these blocks, and I had them up. Alrighty, so our first question comes from Aaron Murphy. Hey, Jag, what is your favorite military fighter jet? Thanks for the question, Aaron. I really appreciate it. Pretty sure I've answered this before, which is no big deal. I will answer it again. I don't have one. 2, 3. Let's see. Let's make 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 is our opening. That might be enough. We might adjust this up. No, seriously, I like all kinds of military fighters. I don't really have a specific one that I really, really like. I'm kind of a bit partial to the F-14, just because, I kind of grew up favoring that one and watching Top Gun and all that kind of shit. I do like the F-18s, because that's the ones that I loaded when I was in the Navy. I like the A-6s. I think those are pretty cool. And, yeah, I got a lot of favorite ones, so I don't have just specifically one that I like in general. So anyways, yeah, I think actually I had probably answered that before, but anyways, thank you for the question. I appreciate that, Aaron.
So anyways, we're going to put 3 more blocks here in the middle. And then we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, I'm going to put here. And then 1, 2, 3, and put right there. And that's going to give us our main opening. And then we'll have glass across the top and then some glass doors on the bottom. And then these pillars are going to go up. We've got 1, 2, 3. Looks like a 4-story building. And let's go ahead and figure out what that's going to be. So there's going to be some side lights here. Oops, I just beat that out right there. Our flooring material, let's use... let's use... I don't really want to use andesite. Let's use the granite for right now for a flooring. And let's see. This is going to be down here. Like that, so we're gonna have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 high, and then the next floor. Should I do double thickness so that I can put lights in it? Probably not, because there's no way in hell I'm gonna finish this, guys. I'm not gonna use, I'm not gonna furnish the inside of this hospital. That would take just, oh my god, entirely way too much time. So no, I'm not going to furnish it for those that are, those that ask. Let's see, this goes back to white. 1, 2, This is going to be the next floor here, and should I make the windows ceiling to floor? I think that would look quite nice, but I think actually the bottom ones I'm going to leave like that, and then these here I'm going to leave at floor levels. So 2, 3, 4, 2, 3, 4. And what do we go? 5? 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So I hope everybody is having a good day, I guess. And I got lost. Forgot what the hell I was doing. Actually, that does not go across there. The white comes out further. And this is where those things go. So I need to stack this up. And I think I'm going to grab it right here. Anyways, I was saying, I hope everybody is enjoying the series and having a good day. And I really appreciate the questions and all the support in this series. I'm going to stack this up. 2 up. So now we got 1, 2, 3, and 4. So there is the height of the building, and this all up here is going to be switched over to the courts. And we've got another question coming up. I was trying to babble something while I was figuring that out, and yeah, total fail on that one. Let's see, we're going to replace 3514 with 155 as courts, and there is the 3 floors above the main entrance. So I think that looks really good, and then we're going to bring this out here. Let's figure out how wide this is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Should we do it? At 4, and then go 1, 2, 3, and then go 1, 2, 3, and then go 1, 2, 3, and that'll give us 4 across here for those thick pieces. And then this gets cut out just like that, so that has a little awning piece. And actually, we're gonna go just like that because those are a little bit longer. Next question.
Juan Pablo Corral Lopez, he is from Colombia, and he says, "Love the channel. Will you learn another language like Spanish?" I actually have taken Spanish before. I can't remember any of it. Well, I can remember some of it, but not very much of it. And I kind of suck at it, and it's sad because Spanish is my background, my heritage. I do have a lot of Spanish in me. My grandparents are from Spain and Hungary. So yeah, I've got quite a lot of Spanish in me. And it's kind of sad I can't speak it. I did at one time, and I took some Spanish in high school. And there's some red here in the middle. It goes back to red on the second floor and bottom of the third floor. So right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It looks like we need to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we'll bring this across because that awning piece sets just like that. So yeah, I had some classes in high school. I think I had a year, or did I have 2 years of it? I think I just had a year of it. It was mandatory, and I did okay. I just didn't do great, probably because I really didn't put forth a good effort.
I wasn't really a daydreamer, but I didn't really pay attention too much. In a lot of my classes, I fucked off a lot. I was young, and I just liked fucking off a lot. So. School was always fun. I got in trouble quite a lot. Let's go in here, just like that, and then here. And we're just gonna flip this once I get this one side done, that way we can get a front up. But yeah, I got in trouble mostly around my high school. The senior and junior year, I got in some trouble. Just because I started getting a little more wilder, and we just, not really destructive, but we just like to be really, really rowdy. And we'd get in trouble quite a bit, and I made a lot of trips down to the principal's office. So me and my friend were always down there getting in trouble, and had some in-school suspension, and I think we got 3 days off one time for, I think we ripped up some books one time. We were being a bunch of dumbasses. Really, really stupid, because we got in trouble for it, and then we had to buy the books. We didn't like reading, and we thought it would be funny if we ripped the pages out of it. So we ripped the pages out of the damn book, and one of the bitches in our class, she ratted us out, and yeah, we ended up getting a suspension for that one. And ended up paying for the book. And actually, these windows up here are not quite that tall. So I think we're gonna go back down on that. And they're definitely longer this way. One's on the bottom floor. Actually, there too. We need to go 1, 2, 3, and then add that. And they're gonna be too high, just like that. That looks better. And then same thing here and here. So yeah, the bitch ran us out, got us in trouble, and it was deserved. You know, like I said, we, you know, we shouldn't have done some shit like that. It was really, really stupid and childish. Funny at the time. It was definitely funny at the time, but it was not funny afterwards. Like I said, we had to pay, I think it was $90 or something for this fucking book. And yeah, it was. My parents were pissed. They were really, really pissed. Like, why would you do something like that? I'm like, I don't know, because it was funny, but it wasn't funny. So anyways, yeah, that's the other language.
Question from Juan Pablo Corral Lopez. Thank you for the question. Next one comes from Austin Wright. Do you know if you ever answered it? Which plane did you arm, the F-18 and F-14s? Okay, I just answered that actually in the last question, so this one kind of ties in, and it was the F-18s. They were phasing the F-14s out when I was in 93. We did have some on the ship. We had one or two, but they were trainers, and they were only trainers. We didn't actually use them for, you know, full-on missions and stuff like that, which we didn't really do a lot of missions when I was in, because we were in dry dock most of the time. So what we did have mainly 14 F-18.
Oop, there we go, a little bit of lag going on. And yeah, there's another set of same thing over here, and then it goes back. So yeah, a little bit of my layout I think is going to be off, but that's fine. Like I said, we will adjust this accordingly. And this goes just above the windows. That's the top of that. This goes up probably, looks like one more. And then this frames it out from behind, just like that. And then there's a set in the middle that is, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4. Who the fuck are we fighting for? There, because these are 4 wide. And again, we're gonna go up by 1 to make it even. And then around the back. So if you're following along, hopefully, trying to keep everything close enough where you can count it. Another reason why I'm using the CUDA shaders, I'm gonna move this out. Let's see, so you can count the blocks. And we're gonna move this way. I'm pretty sure that is north, but anyways, that will give us this little cut piece right here. But you can see a lot better with my pointer, so that you can, you know, kind of count blocks as I'm placing them. That I didn't kind of lay out the blocks. Fuckers. We'll see, as I put the windows in, you'll be able to kind of figure out what I'm doing anyways. But yeah, we've got that piece down the middle, and actually it stops just on the floor above it, so I'm gonna need to get rid of this. And then there's windows. Let's see, that goes across there. And the windows actually sit on the red. So we are still going to go up one more set, because that's where the windows are gonna sit right here. I still think I wanna go flat like that. I think it will look a lot better if I do that. And that means we'll just take this out, and we'll still, I think, get our double high ceilings by doing that. And I think we're gonna go 3 high on the windows for 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I think that'll be okay. Yeah, I think that will work. We'll take this side out, because we want to match the other side, and that will set there, and the glass will go underneath, and this overhangs. Let's see, there's something in the middle. Oh, there's red in the middle. This red goes up just like this, so that will support under there, and then some glass will go in here, and then we'll probably use the dark gray glass just to fill it in, because it looks so much better. And I'm just gonna go ahead and run this up instead of doing a flip-flop, just so we can see what it looks like. And over here, and I think maybe we have another question
from Deer Slaying Redneck. How did you come to YouTube, and your videos make my day hilarious. Love the commentary and the build. So thank you very much, Deer Slaying Redneck, for the questions. And that question I've covered several times, but it's fine. You may be new to the channel. I never wanted to do Minecraft. Had no intentions of ever playing this game. My sons at the time, they were into YouTubing, and they wanted me to start YouTubing with them, and I was like, no, I don't have time for the shit, I really don't want to do it, I just want to play games in my spare time, and that's all I want to do. But they talked me into it, the youngest one actually, and I have been hooked since. So I started playing Minecraft and uploading videos, and the rest is pretty much history.
Uploading videos ever since, and we're coming up on 5 years. I think it's around April, something like that. And we'll be 5 years doing YouTubing, so yeah, that's a long, long time of playing Minecraft. So, but yeah, I've enjoyed it, and I've got a lot of really awesome builds done in them 5 years, and I think I've got a lot better. I'd like to think that I have. We're gonna bring this up just like that for right now and connect that, because what we're gonna do is we're gonna pull this piece here, and we're gonna put it here, and we're gonna put one over there, and that's gonna make the front. And I know this piece is actually a lot longer, and I may cut that down a little bit off camera and kind of scrunch it in a little bit and then take it back. Like, so this is all just a rough layout. It will get adjusted, I am sure.
But anyways, yeah, that is a question for Deer Slaying Redneck, and I think I've got just one more, and this will be the last one for this question. So Brock Latvala, guys, I will mash your name up. I will hack the fucking hell out of it, and I'm sorry. But anyways, he says, what branch do you think is the best? He's thinking about joining the Marine Corps, and can you please list some pros and cons about the different types of branches? Covered this a little bit in different episodes, as far as I've only got experience with the Navy, because that's what I was in. Now my brother, he was in the Marines, and his friend was in the Marines, so I've got a little bit from them. how boot camp was and things like that. And I can tell you right now, the boot camp is longer. It is much more intense because they are, you know, much more grunt based. You know, they're dealing, you know, with a lot of, you know, ground forces, shit like that. Artillery, it's just, you know, there's just a lot more, you know, that's that you've got to deal with. You know, plus, you know, traditionally, you know, Marines has always been, you know, the best of the best. And if you can get through Marine training, you are something else. There is our timer at 25 minutes. So yeah, if you can get through Marine training, definitely kudos and hats off to you, because it takes a very strong mindset, a lot of discipline, and you know, just a lot of different things. It's several weeks, 13 weeks, I think, is boot camp, and they might have changed it, I don't know. And then, of course, I think if you're, you know, just a grunt, you go another 7 weeks for heavy artillery training, but I'm not sure. I can't remember. It's been a long, long time. Navy boot camp is, I don't want to say it's easier, but it is.
We're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I think we're going to go on the windows. And that's going to give us that set here. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we're going to do another set of 9. And then we're probably going to have to crunch this in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And then go up. And then that's where the next piece needs to come in. So we need to do 5 more pieces. 2, 3, 4, 5. And then that is where we're going to bring the other piece in off camera. All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy this piece. And I'm going to drop it in just to the left of this one right here. So again, if you're kind of following along, we just did 9, 5, 9, and then 5, and then we're going to drop that piece right next to it. There's going to be another set of doors here, and then I'm going to go to the right, and I'm just going to mirror and flop everything to that side. So when we pick up next episode, the entire front of the building should be done. I'm going to fill it with glass, and I may actually start the walls going back. So we see what the pattern is. We've got red on the bottom, and then we've got white on the top, and you should know now how many layers we're doing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for the height. So anyways, Brock, that's about all I can tell you about the armed forces. Like I said, I don't have any experience in the Army or the Air Force, so I hope that helps.
Just make sure you prep a lot. Go back to, I think, the B-52 episodes. I talked a lot about boot camp. You can use that in general for some of the other ones too, and hopefully it helps out. But anyways, guys, thank you so much for the questions. Really, really appreciate it. Thanks for clicking that like button, supporting the series, comments, putting the questions. Hey, if you want your question in the video, all you got to do is put it down in the comment section. Hashtag ask JAG makes it a little more clear. That way, when I'm looking through the comment section, I can find it quicker, and I know that it's actually for the series, and it's not just a question you need answered immediately. So like always, guys, I appreciate you watching. Remember to rate, comment, subscribe, follow me on Twitter, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Later.